this here, SMI-35. These are called Fancy Bettys, was her nickname. They'd have been buried right into the ground.
You'd have seen,
if you paid attention, was the little tiny
the second Explorer.
Bounced right out of the ground, then exploded into ball bearings. So they were designed to wound more than kill.
Wounded
one man, got two others trying to look after him. You kill one man, you just got rid of one man. They could have been triggered with side trip wires, which is the same one as their sort of thing.
We've
got here stock mines. Right at the end of the war.
Six-wheel drive, not much that they can't recover, ladies and gents. I think
they're literally just concrete, usually metal bits in. A little stick of dynamite, up inside, tripwire fuse, anti-personnel mine. Nice and simple, nice and cheap, no metal.
Like I say, ladies and gents, we used an Explorer with an eight-wheel drive Scammel last year.
Good old-fashioned telemine.
As a tank vehicle.
So a man could have walked across that, no problem whatsoever.
And it literally pulled.
This would have been set off by a vehicle.
Land Rover in half.
You've had the first guys coming along, the little sticks, finding them, marking them out.
Clean in two.
Second guys would come along to pull them out the ground, deactivate them. The Germans were quite clever. Sometimes they'd put another mine underneath it. Sometimes you'd have a wire going off for Bouncing Betty. While the guy's down on the ground, he jumps up next to him, pull bearings again. Bouncing Bettys are still being found all over the world now. These two particular ones here have come from Russia.